Now let's take a look at the song Love Bites. Now we're going to play this song backwards, and remember how Satan caused violence in heaven? And that's exactly what you hear. It goes to the effect like this. It says, sell violence, and then it comes to a climax where you hear a man scream violence. Now, my friends, let's take a look at a song where you're saying, well, you see, I don't listen to this kind of music. But this song you've heard along with this band. Remember, this is the band that uses the upside down cross with the question mark. The song goes like this. Don't fear the reaper. 20,000 men and women doing it every day. Come on, baby, you can be there too. Don't fear the reaper. Romeo and Juliet are together for eternity. Come on, baby, you can be there too. Don't fear the reaper. The reaper is death. Romeo and Juliet are together in eternity. Romeo and Juliet are together in eternity. 40,000 men win every day. Now that's right, my friends, he's inviting you to come to the Reaper, death, so you could be there too in eternity with Romeo and Juliet. So what's the song about? Well, if you know the story of Romeo and Juliet, their parents did not want them to see each other, so they committed a love pact of suicide. So what's Blue Oyster Cult singing about? Singing about endorsing suicide between teenage lovers. Well, don't be shocked, Ozzy Osbourne's done the same in Suicide Solution, just as did Blondie with Die Young, Stay Pretty, Metallica, Fade to Black, and then the song Don't Fear the Reaper by Blue Oyster Cult.
Singer Steve Tyler.
Censor this and censor that. Kids want to see what it's all about. You know, they want to see David Coverdale hump that microphone. They want to see, sometimes with the loud music, with the rock and roll, with the right chords, some of that sex stuff is okay, you know. I'll be the last one to say it isn't.
Now, my friends, you see, many rock stars have followed the teachings of Aleister Crowley, David Bowie, Quicksand, immersed himself in uniforms of imagery of Aleister Crowley, and said that his album Young Americans resembled Tibetan chants. Stiff Kittens has a picture of Aleister Crowley on the album, just as does Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club LP. They don't stop at Crowley, they also have Karl Marx on there, who started communism. A quick glance at John Lennon's book collection reveals plenty of books on the occult. Now, this never stopped Jim Morrison of The Doors. The 13 album has a miniature statue of Aleister Crowley on it in the back, just as Ozzy Osbourne has sung songs about Mr. Crowley, along with Celtic Frost, a song recorded to Megatherion, which is none other than Aleister Crowley himself. Now, to the radio listener, this might come as a shocker. Hall & Oates. Well, Hall, around 1974, said he graduated into the occult and spent 7 to 6 solid years immersed in the Kabbalah and Chaldean, Celtic, and Druidic traditions. He says he also became fascinated with Aleister Crowley, the 19th century magician who shared some of these beliefs, and put out a video encouraging the Judaic traditions. Psychic Television, along with Current 93, also have used Aleister Crowley to promote some of their music. Now, Eddie is supposedly a lost spirit of which Iron Maiden has control over and bring him to life through their music. This was a practice founded by Aleister Crowley and right into the occult, that is communing with the dead. Now, the Bible speaks against this type of behavior. Here, Charles Manson also plays an important role in the field of rock and roll. In court, when he was charged for the murder of Sharon Tate and LaBianco, he said he had the ability to decipher messages backwards in music while they were being played frontwards. And the reason is clear. You see, he was associated with a man named Anton LaVey, who wrote the Satanic Bible in 1969 and was accustomed to the practice. Well, you see, 1969 plays a major role in history. It was in 1969 that the Satanic Bible was copyrighted and released. It was in 1969 that the first rock and roll Woodstock concert occurred. Again, it was in 1969 that the first homosexual revolution took place on Christopher Street. 1969 marked the year for the saying, "God is dead." Well, again, 1969 played an important role in the life of the Beatles, and that you will see later. Well, my friends, is it any coincidence that the Eagles' Hotels California, the album and the song has this to say in its lyrics? We haven't had that spirit here since 1969, because it was in 1969 that the first Church of Satan was opened up and they cursed the Holy Spirit out of its building. Now, if you don't think you've been deceived, follow this. You see, George Harrison wrote the song, "My Sweet Lord." At the beginning, it says, "Hallelujah, my sweet Lord, hallelujah, my sweet Lord." Listen. Now, my friends, watch what he's done at the end of the song. Instead of saying hallelujah, it's Krishna, my sweet Lord. Krishna is the God that he worships. Now, my friends, you teach children to look forward to the teacher coming out with a bikini bathing suit, and you'll be sorry. Now, you remember the saying? It says this, "My father never told me how to live. He just lived a good life, an honest one, and I watched and followed." Now, children are bound to follow the examples of their parents. So what happens when parents are involved with songs that endorse murder and killing of family members? Sure, the band The Police. Watch the song, the name, Murder by Number. It says this, "Now if you have taste for this experience and you're fleshed with your first success, then you gotta try a twosome or a threesome, cause your conscience will bother you much less. Because murder is like anything you take and do. It's a habit-forming need for more and more. You can bump off every member of your family and anyone else you find a bore." Incest by Prince? It says, "I was only 16, but I guess that's no excuse. My sister was 32, lovely and loose. My sister never made love to anyone but me. Incest is everything it's said to be." Carlos Santana here burns incense to Sharisha Moni, his God, as Christ looks on.